for that on the next SmackDown. Now we're here with Matt Eichhorn as he's getting fired up. Avoided that axe kick.
Oh, another splash. You gotta think you'll be watching that Evan Bourne versus Tyson Kidd match.
Absolutely. But in any case, wait a minute. Matt Eichhorn got him a triumph for the Fatitude Adjustment, but Booker T, veteran counter, knew that move was coming. I don't deny the performance capability of Booker T, but the simple fact...
I slam. Got cover. There's a cover. One, two,
I don't deny the performance capability of Booker T, but the facts, they speak for themselves. Booker T is just not performing at the same level he should be. But Matt Eichhorn, however, he has been pinpoint with his assault on Booker
T. Oh, man. We saw this just last week. Oh, the Tiger Bomb.
Vicious Tiger Bomb as he hooks the leg. Two, no.
And, oh, Eichhorn again. Vicious clothesline.
Discus clothesline. And wait a minute. Eichhorn going for the end. Booker T better be careful. Here it comes, ladies and gentlemen, preparing the weapon. Kill shot.
The kill shot. I thought Booker T might have had a booking in him, but no, it's not. It's over three.
Stick a fork in him. Booker T is done. Matt Eichhorn prevails here tonight. You know, again, I'm not going to take anything away from Booker T, but I do have to think Matt Eichhorn has got to be rolling on pretty high momentum. Lost a little bit of it in the main event last Raw against Stone Cold Steve Austin.
But he redeemed himself here tonight.
Quickly redeeming himself.
Especially after what came up hitting the former King of the Ring winner, Booker T.
Absolutely. Especially with Booker T, of course, again, ladies and gentlemen, is a former six-time World Heavyweight Champion. That definitely does, adds accolades. It adds just prestige to Matt Eichhorn's name.
But each and every win, Eichhorn just continues to look like a strong champion. Maybe one of the strongest in WEDF at the moment.
And really, I don't know what other way to put it for Booker T, but for this man here, Matt Eichhorn, there's barely anything that can stop this man's rise to the top. He's quickly becoming a top name in WEDF, and there looks to be no one who could potentially stop him from reaching his full potential.
I mean, he's been in beast mode since WrestleMania. It's just the drive and the determination to finally reach that title. Eichhorn is in no hurry to lose that title. Anyway, oh man, he's back!
Oh boy. Ladies and gentlemen, you are seeing this right. That is Mr. 305 himself, the former United States Champion, MVP. Wait a minute. Frank Dog, you heard that, right?
Yes, I did.
He's planning on... He's made it simple. He is planning on... Oh, come on, MVP. The fat jokes. Really? Come on now.
You're fat.
305 pounds of pure muscle.
T-H-A-T.
Know you.
Anyway, up next, the world's strongest monster, Mark Henry, is set to be in action against the former two-time United States champion, Val Flyer, and Carlos stop the Hall of Pain.
Back, ladies and gentlemen, we are being joined by Vladimir Kozlov as he is set again to face the world's strongest monster, Mark Henry, in one-on-one action. And really, I don't care how strong Vladimir Kozlov is, I don't care that the man is experienced in the art of sambo wrestling. I don't care if that man's headbutt should be known and feared worldwide.
And I don't think anyone cares now that Vladimir Kozlov took out everyone, including giving Smokey nearly a broken neck many years ago. He's in for, I don't even know if Kozlov later. Whoa!
What? Wait!
I was about to say, well, Kozlov doesn't know what he's in for, but the man, he's back?
He's, wait a minute, something's fishy in the Alamo. He ain't supposed to be facing Abyss. What the hell could this be? Oh my goodness! You're fucking kidding me!
The world's strongest man, Mark Henry, yet again gloating about his achievement.
The world's strongest monster, Frank Dog.
Silverback. The king of the jungle.
You know, I got a word with Mark Henry a little bit before the show started.
How did you even get a word with him? He's so intimidating.
Well, look, I just know how to talk to him without pissing him off. Mark Henry basically told me up front, this is my jungle now. Everybody on Raw should be scared of me. I am the top dog. I am the silverback. If nobody can get it through their skulls, then I'm here to destroy everything in my path and show this whole world that after 16 years of frustration, Mark Henry can be the World Heavyweight Champion, the WEDF Champion at that.
Mark Henry's on a quest, and I've got to say that it might be a matter of time before he becomes champion. So Stone Cold or the winner of the six-pack challenge at Lashing Back, you better be careful.
Everybody better be careful of Mark Henry, man, especially Vladdy Kozlov. I don't
know. Kozlov, he's taking to Mark Henry right now. Bring up the rope, and oh no! Just ran right into a brick wall.
Mark Henry he didn't even like that. He was just like, what are you doing? What are you doing? And Mark Henry is just tearing into Vladimir Kozlov right now, ladies and gentlemen. Kozlov, he just looks completely out of it. And ladies and gentlemen, Vladimir Kozlov is no small man.
He's one of the toughest competitors in WEDF. I mean, here's a man that took out Smokey.
And look at this! Look at how Mark Henry is just tossing him like a rag doll!
This is unbelievable. Mark Henry's taking out the likes of Goldberg, Undertaker, Smokey.
Abyss. Kurt Angle.
Matt Hardy, Dolph Ziggler, El Rojo Mexico, a big splash.
Mark Henry with the cover. 1, 2.
The man who took Benoit out of action.
The list of men that Mark Henry has taken out, it's incredible. It's incredible to you. Well, oh my goodness!
You gotta be kidding me.
It's incredible to think just how much damage Mark Henry has done in months. In just mere months, Mark Henry.
And it all started when he took out Goldberg.
It all started when he just got sick and tired of waiting. It all started, he said, especially on Raw.
When he was on ECW, Mark Henry was tired of rotting in the wait.
15 years of pain and frustration have all led to this, and now Mark Henry is going to run through everybody and put them all in his Hall of Pain.
And Kozlov looks like he's going to join the Hall of Pain right now. World Strong Slam,
and that ought to do it for Vladimir Kozlov. Stick a fork in him, he's done. Wrap it up.
1, 2, 3.
Thanks for coming.
There was no point in counting here.
Should have just rang the bell from the beginning. Mark Henry just outclassed Vladdy Kozlov. Kozlov,
Great Khali was also taken out. I don't think we've seen the Great Khali since.
I don't get.
He's taken out everyone, and Kozlov was just the victim here tonight.
I don't get how Mark Henry just again, the man can do whatever he wants, and he's letting everybody know about it. He is just having his way with everybody in the WEDF.
Is there anyone that can stop?
No! Mark, you've proven your point! You need to do this anymore!
Come on now, really? That's 400 pounds. Is this really necessary?
That is 400 pounds anger and frustration.
That's 320 pounds nearly that Henry just lifted over his head. We took up Batista as well. Don't forget about that.
A second dose of the world's strongest slam! But wait a minute. What? Mark Henry's... What?
No! No!
It's not done! Come on! This isn't... Oh my God! This isn't needed! Vladimir Kozlov! Bleeding like a stuck pig!
My God almighty, you've done enough!
Mark Henry, I guess I gotta keep going with this, Frank Dog. Mark Henry can do whatever he wants, and there's nobody
here. There's no one that can stop him. Security's not even coming out here because they're too scared of...
400 pounds colliding into Vladimir Kozlov again! The Black Weights! That's a bitch's finishing move! The Black Hole Slam!
Finishing the wounds!
What the hell is this all about? Oh man. Ladies and gentlemen, we're being joined by the other three competitors in the back. They're discussing their main event against Austin, Miz, and Cena. Of course, these are the other three men in the six-pack challenge.
That's right. All three men are former WEDF champions, Austin, Miz, and Cena. Ooh, tension's heating up. Triple H claiming to be the leader here.
Christian not one to I don't remember the phrase for it, but he's just not taking a liking to what Triple H is saying here. Okay, now in that situation, I might have to agree with Triple H.
Well, some of those factions did crumble like Evolution fell. Via Triple H.
Absolutely. And wait a minute, Bobby Lashley, you hear those words. Lashley is not taking any of this.
Bobby Lashley not playing games here.
The God of Thunder, the Boss, the Dominator, not take exception.
Especially if they beat Kane last time on Raw. And here comes an American hero, John Bradshaw,
Look how ridiculous he looks in that American flag shirt!
He's a wrestling god, and he's going to explain why he ambushed Samoa Joe last time on Raw backstage. Look at that, he's an American hero, sporting the American colors, red, white, and blue. Red, white, and blue. This is what America is all about.
I don't get why in the world John Bradshaw Layfield, the self-professed wrestling god, I don't get why he attacks Samoa Joe. If the reason that he's an American hero supposedly has something to do with this, then